At NYU, New York University, there is currently a play called The Siege, which is a supposed representation of what happened at the Church of the Nativity in 2002. I was there, and I can tell you that this is a gross misrepresentation of the facts. Those so-called freedom fighters were terrorists, and the 200 civilians inside the church, they were hostages. I was there, and I would like to tell you my story.
I was there, I experienced that, I felt it on my flesh. I spilled some blood over there, and I think I have the right to tell you guys what really happened there when the Israeli army fought against terrorists in Beit Lechem.
Around us, 1,500 journalists from all over the world were just sitting and waiting that something bad will happen to the church.
To understand the siege, we have to understand that Israel had been experiencing a year of terror attacks on an almost daily basis. Every day in Israel was like 9/11. Buses carrying children and fathers and mothers and grandparents were blowing up on every street of Jerusalem. My dear friends who were studying at Hebrew University, when they were eating their lunch, a bomb blew up in a garbage can, killing them. Many of these terrorists came from Bethlehem. Many of these attacks were planned at Bethlehem. We couldn't take this anymore, and we decided to enter Bethlehem to bring these terrorists to justice. When we entered the city, the terrorists fled to a place they felt they would be safe, which was one of the holiest places on earth to Christianity, the Church of the Nativity. We, the IDF, surrounded the building and demanded, first off, that the terrorists let all the hostages go.
The Hamas and other groups try even to burn the church and to accuse Israel of being responsible for the fire. We know that they even dirt the church by not respecting anything inside. They left big dirty mess.
Why do they choose a church? Why do they hold hostages in front of them? You don't hold a hostage of somebody who you care about their life. They clearly didn't care about the monks, they didn't care about the civilians, and those who were brave enough to come forward after, and there weren't many, talked about the disgusting things the terrorists did inside the church, urinating on top of their precious documents in their holy places.
We did not broke into the basilica, but there was a certain service room where they constantly sniped towards Israeli patrols around the church, and at some point we were sent a few soldiers in order to get into this room. And when I was climbing and when I got to the window of that certain room, a terrorist was waiting for me from the other side of the window. Luckily, I was wearing a bulletproof vest. So two of the bullets were stopped by the bulletproof vest, but I got one bullet in my right shoulder and another bullet got into my left arm. A few minutes after I was evacuated, the terrorists from inside, they raised a flag and they called to the Israeli troops in a speaker saying, "We have a wounded man inside," and this was the terrorist who shot me. "Please take him outside, please save his life." He was also evacuated on an Israeli army ambulance for a few minutes. Me and the terrorist who shot me, we were lying in the same ER. And this terrorist got the best medical care from Israeli doctors in an Israeli hospital, and they tried to save his life as well. So I don't know how many armies around the world would evacuate an enemy who would shot their own people just a few minutes before.
I saw a recent video where these terrorists call themselves fighters. A joke, fighters. Fighters fight for freedom. Fighters are noble people. What is noble about blowing up buses of civilians, putting garbage bags full of bombs in cafeterias of schools, and then hiding in a church? That's what a fighter is, that's what a terrorist is.
We know that they want to change the history and they are used to transform reality. But we are not stupid, we are not naive. I hope that you are not naive either.
When it comes time for you to clap for them at the end, I hope you remember that you are clapping for a performance that is glorifying terrorists. Would we do that if they were glorifying Nazis? I see very little doubt.